The Eastern Black Rhino once roamed free in Rwanda, but 10 years ago they had almost disappeared from the savannah, victims of poachers. Now, five rhinos have been reintroduced to a remote national park after a conservation and breeding program in Europe. It's the largest transportation of the critically endangered animal.
Not your usual feeding time.
We love apples.
This is rhino flight training.
Don't get afraid, okay?
With comforting words and lots of apples, the keepers here at this Czech zoo are training rhinos to stand calmly in a confined space. It's something they'll need to do for hours on their upcoming flight to Rwanda. Five young rhinos, all born in European zoos, have been selected to be transported and released into the wild. They're all the descendants of animals that were taken decades ago from Africa.
We have to do everything we can now to, let's say, pay back what we did in the past. And one of the ways how we can do it is to get involved in the conservation projects, like translocating of rhinos from European zoos back to Rwanda and helping establishing a new population in this African country.
These are critically endangered Eastern Black Rhinos, brought together here from three different zoos in preparation for their 6,000-kilometre journey.
They are looking pretty content munching on their breakfast. And these are three of the five animals that are going to be taken to Rwanda for the reintroduction. And they're from all over Europe. They represent the countries that all of these animals come from Denmark, the UK and the Czech Republic.
In the early hours of this morning, the flight they've been preparing for finally arrived at Kigali International Airport. Once unloaded, this most precious of cargo is transferred to trucks for the final stage of the journey. This is their final destination and their first footsteps onto African soil. The rhinos will stay in these specially built bomas for several months while the team checks they're settled, healthy and ready for life beyond the fences.
You see these animals having arrived safely. How does that make you feel?
Very, very happy, and I feel that their survival, their arrival in Rwanda safely, it shows me a future of 100 Rwandans. So, for me, conservation is not just for the sake of conserving, but I see it as a way of improving our life today and the future.
While this is the end of a very long journey, it's just the beginning of what will hopefully be a long life in the wild.